Put my money back. Daddy's, this, and the tape. I need to be all that more tape because that's the only little one I've been using. My second piece, so usually what I do is take pieces and stick them right on the back. Y'all see me over here fighting with this tape, huh? So I found this to be the easiest way. Or, on this little piece here, you can use double-sided tape, but when I went to the store, I couldn't find none, so. Then I didn't know if it had to be a certain kind. Since we are heating this on, I wasn't sure. So, just rolled this. And sometimes when I look at this, to line it up easier is the corners. So down here at the bottom and top. So I come here. See if it's lined up good. So boom, there we go. That's lined up. So I will also take another piece and make sure I have a piece under this piece here so I can pick it up. But I don't. So and I put a piece there. So that piece there is basically done. Boom. This piece is next. Move that all. It's not too hard to do this. To me, it's just time consuming. So I don't think I want to fully offer this until I get a larger heat press so I can tape it all and then press them once to cut down on time, or I get the bigger printer and I can print one sheet out and then press it multiple times. So until then, I don't think I'm gonna really offer this because this does take a long time. And y'all see me on here fighting with tape. yesterday when I just turned my knee press on. This is pretty big for a large, so I still need to do that and get the sizing down for my new size to actually see how big I actually need to go. But I said it's for a large, so it might work. I'm not sure. All right, y'all. So this is one thing that I've been doing also. Like, you see where this meat at in the middle? I usually take the scissors, or you can do that, and just cut that corner off. Just a little bit, not much. Just because it's gonna overlap right there anyway, so it has something to hold on to. Boom. It'll come over a tad bit. Very little. So we'll see, I can see a little line of white. I need to come up. Boom. Guy's face fit in, y'all. D fit in. Fingers in, face in. Alright, y'all. Now, what I do see is. Come on, now. Don't act like that, baby. Come on, now, stay down. Is this D? So I like to make sure my letters are lined up. Good. So that's one thing you can't see. That be off, because a lot of people pull stuff and they be like, it don't have no lines in it. And I'll be like, baby. I see that line. Yeah. They ain't looking the same thing. So that's lined up. Disconnect here, which means that's on there like that. Come on. Boom. It's on there, y'all. So I'll take this in. I'll take a piece, put it there. Put everything behind. And I usually take it and flip it over. And especially take this little piece up. Make sure your piece is taped in so it's not moving. This down here. I make sure they got some tape on them. And it's two. Like right on the end. That's one of the pieces that's gonna be doing a lot of moving. When we're doing this thing. Alright. Take your time, keep it back. Make sure everything on there good. Let me find a shirt. I'm gonna use a large. The large is gonna be under here. I have another large. Don't know where I put it at. Alright, well, don't remember where I put it. Let's get one out of here. So y'all, this is how I do it. I take it and I leave the shirt all the way out. I hope I get over this way, thanks. I don't know if y'all can see, but that's where my name is at, down there. So it might do make sense to add a little other piece on there. So next time I know, I'll shift my design more this way. So this can be right in the middle. Or I can just do it this way and be kind of crooked, but all right y'all, let me pause this and cut this other piece and tape it on there. All right y'all, I'm back. I'm gonna put this piece on here. Now I know I'm gonna have a white spot right here. I was rushing cutting it using the ruler, didn't use the way I told y'all, using the ruler and exacto knife, and the ruler moved, so it cut a line. I refused to take that piece out. So, next thing I'll do is a lint roller. Roll this shirt. Wrong way. Johnny ain't gonna be on this. Is a good thing. y'all. I come and I tape everything down. So this looks like it's about lined up good enough. And I go and tape it down. I stretch it a little bit and tape it. Tape it down. Well, as y'all can see, how it's overlapped, and I'm gonna put it on the bottom too. So me, I take a butcher paper, put it on top and the bottom. On the butcher paper, I don't need all that tape. Use all the tape on that butcher paper. And that piece right there, I messed it up. Y'all see the small pieces I'm putting on now. Shirt tag down. But y'all see the shirt way in here, so I'm gonna flip it, and then I'm gonna come and cut them edges. Cut some of the edges off there.
You know what I do?
Probably so. All right, y'all, that's on there. Somebody come in. Cut some of this off. The shirt about right there. Now you ain't gotta cut it all off. I just cut some of it off because I don't have that single way press and all this can't fit on the there. So I cut what's not needed off. That way I'm more pressing just the shirt. All right, y'all. So I tried to shirt the other way. I was telling y'all, make sure it's taped down good. This wasn't taped down good at the bottom. So I think it may have moved, but I'm not 100% sure. So let's go see. All right, y'all, my phone just died, but I pressed that little bottom piece. Alright, y'all, I do have a dark area, and I know how that happened from when it wasn't, when I went to press that side of the shirt, and it was like down all the way. I didn't have the bottom taped up all the way. Just the shirt, you guys. And this piece, y'all, this happened when I lifted it up the first time. It probably shifted. And it got this big bright glare on that part. But other than that, I think it's a pretty good shirt. Came out cool. Not too many flaws in it. I'll wear it though. Thank y'all for watching.